For this blanket, I made 25 squares. So I've got 5 vertical columns and I've got 5 rows. The next thing you'll do is join your squares together. You can use your favourite method. I'm going to join mine using the flat slip stitch seam. I have a separate tutorial on my channel for this method. I'll link it below the video for you. Before I joined my squares, I decided to block them with the steam from my iron. If you're using acrylic yarn, you probably won't need to do this, but as it's cotton, you can see that they curl a little bit. So I just hovered my iron above the squares. I avoided the rows, I just went round the side, and I released the steam to smooth them out. And make sure that you don't touch the yarn with your iron. If it's acrylic, it will melt. And if it's any other material, you don't want to cause the colour to fade with the really hot temperatures. At this point, I just wanted to show you the progress that I'm making with the seaming. I sew the vertical columns first of all. And then once I've sewed the squares vertically, I'll then do the horizontal seaming. So you can see here, I've still got to do the horizontal seaming. As you can see, I've joined all the squares together and it's now time to move on and begin working on the border. To begin working on the border, I'm going to come to the top right hand corner of my blanket and into the chain 2 corner space, I'm going to attach my yarn. And then I'm going to make a chain of 3. So 1, 2, and 3. And then into the same corner space here, I'm going to work 1 double crochet. And then I'm going to chain 2, 1 and 2. And then I'm going to make 2 double crochet back into the same chain 2 corner space. So there's 1 and 2. And then I'm going to work 1 double crochet into each stitch all the way along to we get to this seam area here. So you'll work 1 double crochet into the next 22 stitches. I've been working my double crochet along the top edge here and I've just come to the join here and you've got a chain 2 space here and a chain 2 space on the other side of the seam. So we're going to work 1 double crochet 2 together over this seam here. So to make the double crochet 2 together, you're going to yarn over hook. Insert your hook into that first chain 2 space and then pull up a loop. You'll have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. You'll have 2 loops on your hook. Then yarn over and insert your hook into the next chain 2 space here, so in here, and then pull up a loop. You'll have 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. You'll have 3 loops on your hook. yarn over and pull through all three loops. And there's the double crochet two together. And then you're going to continue working one double crochet into the next 22 stitches until you get to the next seam, and you'll do exactly the same. You'll work one double crochet two together over these two chain two spaces. So again, I've been working my double crochet stitches all the way along this square here at the top, and I'll show you one more time how to do the double crochet two together over these chain two spaces. So I'm going to yarn over hook, insert my hook into this chain two space here, and pull up a loop, then yarn over and pull through two loops, then yarn over, insert your hook into the next chain two space, and pull up a loop, and then yarn over and pull through two loops, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops to complete the double crochet two together. And then we're just going to continue working in the same way all the way along the top edge until we get to the next corner here. So you'll work one double crochet into each stitch and then work your double crochet two together over the chain two spaces. So continue working in this way until you get to the next corner of your blanket. I've been working my stitches all the way along the top edge of the blanket, and I've come to the next corner here. So I'm going to do exactly the same as what I did in the first corner. So I'm going to work two double crochet, chain two, and then two double crochet into the corner space. So we'll work one and then another one. Then chain two. And then work two double crochet back into that chain two corner space. So there's one. And two. And then down this side of the blanket and across all the remaining sides of the blanket, you're going to do exactly the same as you did along the top edge. So you're going to work one double crochet into each stitch and then work one double crochet two together into the chain two corner spaces. And when you get to the next corner, you're going to work your two double crochet, chain two, and your two double crochet. So you're going to repeat this all the way around the blanket, and I'm going to do this off camera, and I'll meet you when I arrive back at the beginning again, and I'll show you how to close the round and then begin working on the second round of the border. I've been working my stitches all the way around the blanket, and I've come back to the beginning, and I'm going to slip stitch into the top of the chain three that I made at the beginning. So one, two, and three. I'm going to slip stitch into that top chain. And that's the end of round one. For round two, we're going to slip stitch into the next stitch here. And then slip stitch into the chain two space. And now we're ready to begin round two, the begin our corner. So we'll do the corner as before. We'll chain three, one, two, and three. And this counts as your first double crochet. And then we'll work one double crochet, chain two, and then we'll work two double crochet into the same space. So there's one and then two. And then for round two, it's really simple. You're just going to work one double crochet into each stitch all the way along the top edge here, and you'll work your double crochet into that double crochet into the top of the double crochet two together here. So just work one stitch into each double crochet all the way along to the next corner, where you'll work the corners as before. So two double crochet, chain two, and then two double crochet, and you'll do this along each side of the blanket. So work your stitches, double crochet stitches, work the corners as normal, and I'll meet you back at the beginning and we'll just close the round together and then we'll start on round three. I've been working around the blanket and I've come back to the beginning of round two, and I'm going to, as before, I'm just going to slip stitch into the top of the chain three to join the round. And then for round three, again, we want to begin in the chain two corner space. So I'm going to slip stitch into the next stitch here. And then slip stitch into the chain two space. And for round three, you'll repeat round two. So you'll work your corner. Begin by chaining three, then work one double crochet, chain two, and then work two double crochet back into that corner space. And then you're just going to work one double crochet into each stitch along each side of the blanket, working your corners, which will be two double crochet, chain two, and two double crochet. So repeat round two for round three, and then I'll meet you back at the beginning and we'll close the round together and then we'll begin working on round four. I've just finished working round three and I've come back to the beginning again. So I'm going to slip stitch into the top of the chain three to join the round. And we're now finished with the white yarn. So I'm going to grab my scissors and I'm going to cut my yarn. And then pull the yarn through. And then all you need to do is weave this little tail in to the back. Before we start on round four, I just wanted to show you that this is what your border will be looking like at this point. So for rounds two and three, I just worked my corners, two double crochet, chain two, two double crochet into that chain two corner space. And I just worked one stitch, one double crochet into each stitch, all the way along to the next corner. And then I worked my corner again. And I did this all the way around the blanket, around all four sides. So really simple. We're now going to work on round four. So for this, grab your pink yarn and we'll get to work on round number four. To begin round four, I'm going to come up to the corner of my blanket and I've got the chain two corner space here. I'm going to attach my yarn into this first double crochet here. And then I'm going to make a chain of three. So one, two, and three. And then back into the same stitch, I'm going to work six double crochet. And the chain three counts as your first double crochet. So there's one, two, three, four, five, and six. So the chain three counts as a double crochet, so you'll have seven double crochet. And then I'm going to skip the next two stitches, so one and two. And then into the third stitch, I'm going to work one single crochet. And then I'm going to skip the next two stitches, one and two. And then into the third stitch, I'm going to work seven double crochet. So there's my seven double crochet, and then I'm going to skip the next two stitches, one and two, and then into the third stitch, I'm going to work one single crochet. And then skip the next two stitches, one, two, and into the third stitch, work seven double crochet. and then skip the next two stitches, one, two, and then make a single crochet into the third stitch. And this is the sequence that you're going to repeat all the way along the top edge of the blanket. So work this repeat all the way along to the next corner, and I'll show you what to do when you get to the corner of your blanket. I've been working my shell stitches along the top edge, and I made my last single crochet here just before the corner. So you should have two stitches remaining and then the chain two corner space. So I'm going to skip this stitch here and then into the next stitch just before the chain two corner space, I'm going to work my seven double crochet. So there's my seven double crochet, and then into the chain two corner space, I'm going to work a single crochet. And then into the first double crochet here, I'm going to work seven double crochet. So there's my seven double crochet, and then I'm just going to continue working the pattern all the way down the second side until I get to the next corner, where I'll make my last single crochet, then I'll skip the next stitch, and then into the stitch right before the chain two space, I'll work seven double crochet. And then into the chain two corner space, I'll work my single crochet, and then I'll work seven double crochet into the stitch immediately after the chain two space. And you'll do this down each side of the blanket and in each corner of the blanket as well. I've been working my shell stitches all the way around the blanket, and I've come back to the beginning, and I just worked my seven double crochet here into that last stitch, and then I've got the chain two corner space. I'm going to work my single crochet into that corner space. And then to join the round, I'm going to come to the beginning chain three, and into the top, I'm going to join with a slip stitch. And that's the end of round four. And you can stop here if you like. It looks really pretty with just the shell border in the contrasting color, or you can continue and work the next few rounds. So at this point, you're going to grab your scissors and cut your yarn, and then grab your tapestry needle and just weave this little end in. To begin round five, we're going to attach our yarn, our white yarn, into one of the corners. So I've got the shell here, and then a single crochet, and then another shell. I'm going to attach my white yarn into the single crochet. And then I'm going to make a chain of five. So one, two, three, four, and five. And this chain five counts as a double crochet and a chain two. And then back into the same stitch, I'm going to work one double crochet. And then I'm going to chain two, one and two. And then I'm going to make another double crochet back into the same stitch. And then I'm going to chain two, one and two. And then I'm going to make my last double crochet back into the same stitch. So I'll have one, two, three, chain two spaces. And then I'm going to make a chain of five. So one, two, three, four, and five. And then I'm going to skip the next shell stitch. And then into the single crochet, I'm going to work one double crochet. And then I'm going to chain two, one and two. And then back into the same stitch, I'm going to work one double crochet. And I've just made a V-stitch. And then I'm going to chain five, one, two, three, four, and five. And then I'm going to skip the shell stitch, and then into the single crochet, I'm going to make another V stitch. So I'm going to double crochet. Chain two, one, two. And then one double crochet back into the same stitch. And there's my V stitch. And I'm going to repeat this all the way along the top of the blanket. So chain five, skip the shell stitch, and then make a V stitch into the single crochet. So work this sequence all the way along to the next corner, and I'll work the corner with you, which is the same, exactly the same as this first corner, but I'll do it with you once we reach the other side. I've come to the next corner and I've just worked my last V stitch before the corner. So I'll chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then I'm going to skip the shell stitch and then I'm going to make a double crochet into that single crochet. And then I'm going to chain 2, 1, 2. And then I'm going to work one double crochet back into the same stitch. And then chain 2, 1, 2. And then double crochet back into the same stitch. And then chain 2, 1, and 2. And then I'm going to make one final double crochet into the same stitch again. And this is how you'll work each corner. So I'll have 1, 2, 3 chain 2 spaces. And then I'll just continue working as before. So I'll chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then skip the shell and then work my V stitch into the single crochet. So just repeat the sequence all the way around the blanket and I'll meet you back at the beginning and we'll close the round together. I've just finished working round 5 and I've come back to the beginning again. So to join the round, I'm going to come over to the beginning chain 3 and into the top of that chain 3, I'm going to join with a slip stitch. And then at this point, we're finished with the white yarn. So I'm going to cut my yarn and then I'm going to just weave this little tail into the back. To begin round 6, I'm going to get my pink yarn and I'm going to start in the corner and you can see that there's 1, 2, and 3 chain 2 spaces. So into the first space here, I'm going to attach my yarn. And then I'm going to chain 3. 1, 2, and 3. And then back into the same chain 2 space, I'm going to work 6 double crochet. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the chain 3 counts as your first stitch, so you'll have a shell of 7 stitches here. And then I'm going to come over to the next chain 2 space. So in here, and I'm going to work one single crochet. And then into the next chain two space here, I'm going to work my shell of 7 double crochet. So 1, 2, and 7. So there's my other shell. So I've got a shell here, single crochet in the middle, and then another shell. And then I'm going to come over to the next shell here, down in this row below, and into the fourth stitch of the shell. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this fourth stitch is the middle stitch. I'm going to work one single crochet. And I'm going to make sure that I catch this chain five here. There's my single crochet, and then I'm going to work into the next V stitch. I'm going to work another shell of 7 double crochet. So there's my shell into that V stitch, and then I'm going to come over to the next shell here, and again into the fourth stitch. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'm going to work one single crochet, and I'm going to make sure that I'm catching this chain five as well. And this is what I'm going to be doing all the way around the blanket. So I'll work my shell of 7 double crochet into the next V stitch, and then I'll come over to the shell here, and into the middle stitch, the fourth stitch, I'll work one single crochet. So you're going to repeat this all the way around the blanket. And into the corners, you'll do exactly the same. And I'll show you that one more time when I get to the next corner. But for now, you're just going to work your shell stitches and then your single crochet. I've been working my shell stitches all the way along this side of the blanket, and I've come to the next corner. I've worked my single crochet into the middle of this shell stitch here, and in the corner I've got my 3 chain two spaces. Into the first chain two space here, I'm going to work one shell, which is of course 7 double crochet. So there's my shell And then into the next chain two space, I'm going to work one single crochet. And then into the last chain two space here in the corner, I'm going to work another shell stitch. And then I'm just going to carry on as before. So I'm going to work one single crochet into the fourth stitch, into the middle stitch of this shell. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then move over to the next V stitch and I'll work my next shell stitch. And this is what you're going to do all the way around the blanket. So work the pattern all the way around the sides, and then when you get to the corner, you'll work your shell stitch, single crochet, and then your shell stitch. So I'm going to continue working this off camera again, and I'll meet you back at the beginning and we'll close the round together, and then we'll begin working on the final round. I've been working the pattern all the way around the blanket, and I've come back to the beginning, and as you can see, I made my single crochet into the middle of the shell stitch, and now I've arrived back at the corner where we started. And I'm going to slip stitch into the top of the chain three to join the round. And that's the end of this round. And we're finished with the pink colour now. So again, I'm just going to cut the yarn and then I'm just going to weave this little tail into the back to hide it. We're now ready to start working on round 7, which is the final round of the border. So I'm going to begin working in one of the shell stitches here. And for this round, we're going to be working in the back loops only. So these are the front loops. We want to be working into the back loops. So I'm going to come over to the first double crochet here of this shell stitch, and I'm going to attach my white yarn into the back loop only. And then I'm going to chain one. And then into the same stitch, I'm going to work one single crochet. And then I'm going to work one single crochet into the next 6 stitches. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 6. And then we've got the single crochet here. I again, I'll be working into the back loop only, and into the single crochet, I'm going to make one slip stitch. And then I'm going to work one single crochet into the back loop only of each stitch in the shell stitch here. And seven. And then into the single crochet into the back loop only, I'm going to work one slip stitch. And this is the sequence that you're going to repeat all the way around the blanket. So you'll be working into the back loops only. So into the 7 double crochet of the shell stitch, you'll work single crochet into the back loop only. And then in the single crochet here, into the back loop, you'll work your slip stitch. And when you get to the corner, it'll just be the same. You'll work your single crochet into the shell stitch. And then into the single crochet, you'll work a slip stitch. And then you'll work your single crochet into the back loop only of the next shell stitch at the corner. So I'm going to work this pattern all the way around the blanket, and I'll meet you back at the beginning again. I've just finished working round 7 and I've come back to the beginning again. And into the first single crochet that I made, I'm going to join the round with a slip stitch. And then I'm going to cut the yarn. And then I'm just going to weave my ends in. And here's the blanket all finished. I decided to block my blanket. I ordered some blocking mats from Knit IQ, which are really good. And I just laid the blanket out on the mat and hovered my iron just above it. Be careful that you don't touch the blanket with your iron. As I was steaming it, I used my other hand to pat and smooth out the blanket. It will feel a little bit damp, so leave it on the mat until it's completely dry before moving it. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks for watching.